It may be hard to see it now, but COVID may just have an incredible silver lining. The lasting legacy of this pandemic may just be a new treatment for HIV, cancer, even malaria. How? Well, this story begins with the daughter of a butcher who grew up in Hungary. Her name is Catalin Carrico. In her 20s, she moved to the US after getting married and having a baby. But for better or worse, she was also married to her job. Her husband reckons that with the endless hours she put in, it probably amounted to her earning about a dollar an hour.
And she was applying for grant after grant after grant. She kept getting knocked back, getting told this is just too far-fetched.
That's right, for decades, literally decades, no one paid any attention to this biochemist. In fact, many people laughed at her. That was until recently when she caught the attention of two companies. You might have heard of them, Moderna and BioNTech, the maker of the Pfizer vaccine.
We've had millions of people all around the world injected with these mRNAs. It's really opened the floodgates to thinking about all the other diseases that could be helped by this mRNA technology.
Before the pandemic hit, traditional vaccines worked by injecting a weakened or inactive virus to trigger an immune response. But Catalin's mRNA research is a game changer. It works like this. The mRNA is a little messenger, which temporarily makes your own body produce a tiny and harmless part of the virus. With COVID, that's the so-called spike protein. Your immune system then figures out how to fight and remove that protein so that if it ever gets infected by the actual virus, it can find it and kill it much quicker.
This really is revolutionary for the medical world, and it is genuinely a disruptive technology.
And that's because the technology can be quickly modified to tackle other diseases. So Catalin's plan to use mRNA could be used as a vaccine for malaria, a treatment for HIV, multiple sclerosis and tuberculosis. In a year or two, it could even be used as an immunotherapy for cancer. Clinical trials are underway right now.
So the idea is that your immune system would kind of weaken your tumour and allow it to kind of open up and have the chemotherapy go in and attack.
So if this can treat cancer and HIV and even prevent malaria, why hasn't mRNA vaccines come onto the scene before now? The simple answer is dollars. No one wanted to invest in it. The irony now is that governments everywhere are chucking billions at it. Australia wants a slice of the action too. The government says it's going to spend $1.5 billion to kickstart its own capacity to manufacture mRNA vaccines and treatments.
So get excited, absolutely, be excited. It's real, it's not just a promise.
So if all of this has come about pretty much from one Hungarian woman sticking to her guns, the pandemic's proven that the brains were there all along, they just needed the bucks. Which begs the question, what other cures could be sitting in a lab somewhere just waiting for someone to invest?